हेलो चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू? आई एम विजय श्रीयादव फ्रॉम तत्व इंडियन ग्रुप पब्लिक स्कूल भोपाल. टुडे आई विल टीच यू रेस पार्ट ऑफ द टेंस विच आई हैव टॉट यू यस्टरडे. कल मैंने आपको बताया था देयर आर थ्री टाइप ऑफ द टेंसेस, प्रेजेंट, पास्ट एंड फ्यूचर, एंड थ्री टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस आर देयर, अफर्मेटिव, नेगेटिव एंड द इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंसेस. नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ऑल टेंसेस. You know, all these three tenses have four forms. First is present, simple past and simple future. Second is present continuous, past continuous and future continuous. Third is present perfect, past perfect and future perfect. And fourth is present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense and future perfect continuous tense. So tense has four form. So total there are 12 tenses. So now let us begin. Now I have given you structure of all the tenses. Now first is simple present tense. In simple present tense, we always use the structure of the simple present tense is subject plus verb. With verb we have to use s or es. Suppose go, goes, works. So we have to use s and es and plus object. You know where to frame any sentences we have to need three things. I have already told you about that. One is subject, second is verb and third is object. To make a complete sense of any sentence, we need three things: subject, verb and object. If you suppose I work hard, here I is a subject, work is a verb and hard is a object. Okay, so to complete any sentences, we need three things: subject plus verb plus object. All I, we, you, they, he, she, it, all these are called the subject. The name of anything, either it will be a name of a person, place, animal or thing, this is called the subject. Now let us begin. Simple present tense. In simple present tense, we always use subject, verb, plus s or es and object. For example, she works hard. Works, here we use s, right? We always use with third person, he, she, it, s or es, and to other first person and second person, we not use with them s or es. Now second is present continuousness. Continuousness, किसी verb को हम लगातार करते रहते हैं. This is called the continuous. So in the present continuous tense, we always use subject plus is or am, first form of the verb and object. Suppose I am teaching you, मैं आपको पढ़ा रही हूँ. I teach you मतलब पढ़ाती हूँ. अगर मैं आपको लगातार पढ़ा रही हूँ, तभी से I am teaching you, मैं अभी भी आपको पढ़ा रही हूँ. Here I is a subject, am is a helping verb, teaching is a verb. And you is an object. So here with verb I use ing. Teach is a verb. And इस teach में हमने ing लगाया. So now it became a continuous tense. So the structure of present continuous tense is subject plus is or am, first form of the verb plus ing and object. Now third is present perfect tense. In present perfect tense, we always use has, subject plus has or have, third form of the verb and object. Third form of the verb means suppose I have to say write. Write is a first form. WROTE, wrote is a second form and written is a third form. So in always present perfect tense, either it be present perfect tense, past perfect tense or future perfect tense, we always use third form of the verb. Now let's go here. In the present perfect tense, we always use subject plus has, have, third form of the verb and object. Now look here, in the past perfect tense, we always use with the subject have. Look here, what is the difference between the present perfect and past perfect? In present perfect tense, we always use has or have. In past perfect, we always use had and third form of the verb. And in future perfect, we always use will have or shall have, third form of the verb plus object. Is it clear? Now next is, for example, he has completed his work. This is the present perfect tense. In the past perfect tense, we will say he had. What will we use here? Had. He had completed his work. In the future perfect tense, we will say he will have completed his work. Okay. So in the present perfect, we use has had. In past perfect, we use had. Third form of the verb, and in future perfect we use will have or shall have. Okay, and third form of the verb. Always in perfect tense we use third form of the verb. Either it will be a present perfect, past perfect, or the future perfect. Now last is present perfect continuous tense. In present perfect continuous tense, continuous again I repeat you, किसी काम को हम लगातार कर रहे हैं. In present perfect continuous tense, we always use has been with subject, we always use has been, have been, plus first form of the verb, ing, and object. Now look here, what is the difference between a perfect tense and perfect continuous tense? In perfect tense, we always use third form of the verb with have or has in present tense. But in perfect continuous, present perfect continuous tense, we always use has been, have been, plus ing. Verb ke saath hum ing. We are not using here third form of the verb. We are using here verb plus ing. I have been reading you since last 2 hours. Hum kisi bhi verb ko lagatar kar rahe hain 2 ghante se. If the time is confirmed, then we will use since. If we don't know if time, we don't know about the time, from how many hours I am teaching you, then we will use for. Next, past perfect tense. In past perfect tense, we always use had been. Again, I repeat you, with present perfect continuous tense, we will use have been, has been. In past perfect continuous tense, we will use had been. And in future perfect continuous tense, we will use will have been or shall have been. In future tense, we always use will or have. Okay? So, in future perfect tense, we will use will have been or shall have been. And first form of the verb plus ing and object. Suppose, I will have been teaching you since 2 hours. What I have written? I will have been. In present tense, present perfect tense, I told you, I have been teaching you since 2 hours. In past tense, it will be I have been teaching you since 2 hours. In future tense, we will say I will have been teaching you since 2 hours. Clear? Again, I repeat you. I recall you again. In simple present tense, we always use S, ES. In simple past tense, we always use subject plus second form of the verb and object. He played football. Usne football khela. In present tense, it will be he plays. In past tense, he played. In future tense, he will play. In future tense, simple present future tense, we will use first form of the verb plus will and shall. Now look at the continuous tense. In present continuous tense, we will use is RM, subject plus is RM, first form of the verb ing plus object. I am teaching you. Okay. In past tense we will use I was teaching you. Main aapko padha rahi thi. I was teaching you. In future tense we will say I will teach you. Main aapko padhaungi. So you have to find the difference. here we use only second form of the verb. Oh, sorry. Here we use was and were in the past tense. Continuous tense. In future continuous tense, we will use will be or shall be. Next is present perfect tense. In present perfect tense, we use has or have and third form of the verb plus object. In past perfect tense, we will use had or third form of the verb. Suppose I have completed my work. In past perfect tense, I will say I have completed my work. And in future perfect tense, I will say I will have completed my work. In perfect tense, we always use third form of the verb. Now last is present perfect continuous tense. किसी भी काम को हम लगातार किए जा रहे हैं. So in present perfect continuous tense, we will use subject plus has been or have been. In past perfect continuous tense, we will use had been, and in future perfect continuous tense, we will use will have been or shall have been. For example, I have been reading this chapter since last 2 hours. In past perfect continuous tense, we will say I have been reading this chapter. In future perfect continuous tense, we will say I will have been reading this chapter since 2 hours. Is clear? Now you have to read carefully, listen carefully, and thank you. Have a nice day.